Hello all, this is Rajesh Nadigadda from G. Pullareddy Engineering College. Now, I want to share my idea on managing of wildlife with a human life. Generally, wild animals get attracted to the human areas or villages that are close to the wildlife sanctuaries. Interaction between wild animals and the people and the resultant negative impact on people or their resources or wild animals or their habitat. It occurs when growing human populations overlap with the established wildlife territory and creating reduction of resources or life to some people and their wild animals. As populations expand to wild animal habitats, due to increase in population day to day, there is a less space for more people. That's why they were preferring deforestation, that is, they would cut trees and construct various buildings to live. Coming to the main causes and effect of this entering of animals into the villages, there will be injury and loss of life of animals and wildlife, and crop damage due to the entering of animals and foxes into the farms of farmers in villages, and damage due to the human property and trophic cascades, and destruction of habitat due to the electric fences like that of destruction properties, and collapse of wild animal populations and reduction of geographic changes. Coming to the management techniques, the management techniques of wildlife are two types. The first type are the traditional techniques, which aim to stop, reduce or minimize the conflict by controlling animal population in different ways. Already known one, the lethal control has a longest history but has major drawbacks. Potential solutions to avoid the entering of animals into the villages are electric fencing, land use planning, ecotourism, and growing of more chili pepper plants. This will obstruct the movement of animals through fields and farmers. Now, according to my plan, now I want to take the help of GPS, that is Global Positioning System, and GIS, Global Information System, to track the animals and keep the animals away from the villages. GPS satellite navigation receivers are increasingly being used in ecology and behavior studies to track the movements of animals in relation to the environments in which they live and forage. Advances in crops technology now mean that submeter precision systems can be utilized to track animals. The use of submeter systems being both new scientific opportunities and new technological challenges. For example, the fitting of all animal in a group with a submeter precision GPS receivers allows their relative inter-visual distances to be precisely calculated, and their relative orientations can be derived from a data from a digital compass fitted to the receiver. These data analyzed using geographical information system could give new signals and to the social behavior of animals. The combination of automatic satellite navigation based animal tracking, the automatic recording of foraging behavior and vegetation or habitat maps used in ground surveys of aerial satellite images allow. So now, how can we record the location of animal by using GPS? Initially, animal tracking relied on manual or aerial observation of animal, with the position of the animal being estimated with a reference to the landscape features, that is usually with a reference to a map. This approach was limited value, as unless the animal was continuously followed, which was clearly very expensive in terms of effort, the focal animal would first have to be located before its position could be recorded. Such close tracking of animal by human also risked influencing the animal's natural movement patterns, so risked compromising the tracking data. And also recording the foraying behavior of animals. Just as with recording animal position, the simplest approach to recording the foraying behavior of animals in my best direction observation. However, for studies requiring data to be collected over long periods of time, manual observation is laborious and expensive. Coming to this GPS precision and accuracy, the important to distinguish between the precision and accuracy of this global positioning system receivers. Precision refers to the repeatability of the position as recorded by the GPS receiver at the fixed point, whereas accuracy refers to the any discrepancy in the position calculated by the GPS receiver and the position as determined by the reference to the published map. The accuracy of GPS is therefore very much related to the accuracy of published map, and the precise nature of GPS has shown the limitations of many maps produced before GPS was available. Finally, the final action by the government. After tracking of any animal which is very near to the village, that particular location will be sent to the surrounding forest officers through the message from satellite automatically. Then the forest officers will alert and take some precautions to give alert signals to the surrounding villages, and these forest officers must try to send the particular animal into the forest by normal methods. Now, how my plan is different from others. For example, in electronic fencing, the animals may die due to the shocking of animals. This will cause to the unbalance in environmental. But in my plan, when we can did the entire project through GPS and GIS, already more and more satellites are there to give the information. This didn't cause any harm to the both animals and humans. In this way, my plan is different from others. The final conclusion is, using GIS to integrate and analyze the data from concurrent automatic GPS animal tracking, automatic foreign behavior recording and precise vegetation mapping provides a very powerful tool for those investigating the spatial aspects of foreign behavior in complex natural environments. Until a commercial supplier develops a fully integrated system, scientists face the technical challenge of integrating the various components that make up the system. However, for those willing to take on the challenge, the benefits are considerable. Thank you for giving this platinum opportunity.